¿cómo están? Yo soy Ailed y como pueden ver, este es un video un poco diferente porque ya nos llegó la placa de 1,000,000 de suscriptores.
¡Ah! I don't understand what you're saying, but I get you're excited. I am too.
¡Yes! Así es que como no quería abrir la placa sola, invité a Michael.
¡Hi!
A que me ayudara a abrir esto. Y pues les pedí a ustedes que me escribieran preguntas que tenían acerca de nosotros, del canal, de todo. How are you?
Hola chicos. I'm good. I'm very excited. This has been a long time coming.
It is.
We actually had a like hi YouTube. We passed 1,000,000 like 6 months ago. Where's our plaque?
Yeah, I know.
And they were like, oh yeah. Okay, yeah, we'll get that to you.
Yeah.
I don't think the channel's being made in Canada. I don't think.
I don't know why they took so long for them to bring the plaque, but here it is.
So we're gonna open this.
Yeah, but first I think that we should answer some questions that the viewers made.
Okay. Are they about you?
About us.
Good.
About the channel. They are pretty interesting. I'm excited.
Okay, that's very cool. Like, I feel like because you do so much reporting on celebrities and stars, they probably don't know a whole bunch about you.
Yeah, I think that they are always like curious about myself.
Well, that's awesome that they get to see more about you.
Yeah.
And how you started doing this. I will tell them everything. I feel like it's at 1,000,000. That's when I did my Before They Are Famous. So I'm like, when are you gonna do yours?
I think that maybe 1.5.
1.5? That's coming around. Like you're at 1.2 now?
Yeah, so maybe.
Maybe at 2,000,000.
Yeah, I think that maybe 2 would be a great number.
Why don't you help Ailed out, guys, by sharing this channel with your friends, those who don't know about it. Get her to 2,000,000 and then she can tell you her entire Before They Are Famous story.
That would be like really interesting, I think.
Yeah, you've like lived a crazy life. You moved to Canada all by yourself. I found you in this college class and you didn't know what you were gonna do. She's trying to work in television. I'm like, television's over.
Yeah, there's no television anymore, so he saved me.
She's very fun to work
with.
And I like your dress, by the way.
Oh yeah, my dress. Hey, so shout out to Fashion Nova.
And Fashion Nova men.
Ooh.
Boom! They hooked us up with a bunch of clothing. We're getting Ailed more outfits for her show. And we got a little sponsorship in this video, but we just need to thank them because they're helping pay the bills. All right, should we jump into some questions?
Yes, are you ready?
Yes.
Okay, first question. Cynthia pregunta, ¿cuál ha sido el video más difícil que han hecho?
Whew. I'm sure we both have way different answers.
Yeah, of course.
For me, off the top of my head, there's this YouTuber by the name of Filthy Frank, and he played this wild character who would like shave his head and do all sorts of like eating pubes, like gross stuff. But it was all a character. And at the time, the guy had like hidden his personal identity, so like I was doing a bio on a character and I couldn't figure out anything about the guy. And I think that video went viral. So it was a little awkward to like not really know what was going on. Yeah, and then he actually like reacted to it and was like, none of this is right.
Really?
Yeah! Oh. You know, you live and you learn.
And for me, I think that the most difficult video that I've made,
6 horas después,
Anuel AA was the hardest for me because there was no info on this guy. So it was just like weird that like, there was no info and everybody wanted to know something about him. So actually I'm updating. Estaré actualizando ese video pronto. Así es que díganme si es algo que quieren ver. Muchos de ustedes me lo han pedido porque ya salió de la cárcel. So he's out of jail now. So now I'm updating that video on him. So hopefully I'll have more information on that and it's gonna be a more interesting video.
He's totally gonna watch it.
Yeah, of course.
You've become famous because of your show Before They Were Famous.
Yeah, famous.
Like you're in music, like they some guy.
Oh yeah, the Farruko thing. Okay, so Farruko me escogió parte del video de Antes de que fueran famosos que hice en él y lo puso en una canción que se llama Más dinero, más problemas. Entonces, en la intro de ese video, de su video musical, sale mi voz hablando de Farruko antes de que Farruko...
Carlos Efrén Reyes Rosado nació en Bayamón, Puerto Rico, el 2 de mayo de 1991.
And it had like 34 million views or something like that. Yeah, it
his
was
song?
Like, yeah.
Huge.
Yeah, that's the only huge thing that has happened to me.
Yeah.
La siguiente pregunta es de Videos Random y dice, ¿cómo conociste a Michael y cómo surgió la idea de hacer este tipo de videos? Me gustan tus videos. Saludos desde Argentina.
Okay, so Before They Were Famous was probably a year up and running, maybe just under a year. And then I would go back to this college that I had, I was enrolled in. I think I graduated there in 2012.
Really?
What year were you there?
2015.
Yeah. Anyway, you were a student in this class.
Yeah.
And I was like, I just hit it big. I got this YouTube channel and it pays the bills. And all these kids are like, I want to write for The Simpsons.
Yeah.
They're like, I'm like, forget it. It's all about YouTube. Anyway, out of all the people, you took a strong interest in my presentation and what I was up to. And then I'm like, you know, the second biggest language in the world is Mandarin, but they have their own YouTube. So the third biggest language is Spanish.
Yay!
And I'm like, why don't we try doing that?
Yeah.
So you pick it up from there.
So after that, you like, I was like, hey, so I made this video for my production class, and I showed you the video that I made, and it was like a YouTube video where I was like explaining slangs from Mexico, and you were like, oh, that's cool, and you were like, do you wanna do like some translations, some dubs?
Yeah. So I wanted to, like, I didn't know if it was gonna work, so I'm like, let's just take the videos we have and change the voice. So we had female hosts at the time, so I'm like, let's just put your voice over top.
Yeah.
Como siempre, déjenme saber en los comentarios abajo de quién más quieren que hablemos.
And we did that, but people didn't really like, it wasn't real. So then we were like, well, why don't you just host it?
Yeah.
And you'd hosted television shows back home?
Yeah, well, I used to work in television back home, so I was just like, I did some appearances here and there, and it was just like whatever there.
She told me she was a TV host, no! So I was like, oh, you got this!
It was not a TV host.
Are there clips of this?
Yeah, I have some clips.
You're before they're famous! Yes!
En esa novela siempre lo que me gusta...
No me digas oír, Carlos.
El chavo este...
So yeah, like you told me, do you wanna host one of the videos? And my first video that I hosted was Yuya. Mm. Yuya before they were famous.
YouTuber.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Su gusto por el maquillaje le impulsó a subir su primer video a YouTube a la edad de 16 años.
It's weird to watch those videos now.
You've changed a lot.
Yeah.
You've changed a lot.
A lot.
But that's YouTube, right? You get in and then you just see where it takes you. Did the Yuya video do well?
It was okay.
Because YouTubers are hard to do because they populate their name so much. It's hard to like, for people to find your video versus like someone who does music. They'll pull up a few music videos, but then there's more, like not as much content like what we do on them.
Yeah, exactly. Mm. So it was hard for me to, so I was actually stalking Yuya on Yuya's videos. I was just like, hey guys, if you wanna know more about Yuya, just go to this video. And I was linking it to my Before They Were Famous video. I was doing that kind of things. Yeah, that was weird.
Well, you have to do whatever it takes. Obviously, things took off. What was your first video to get like a million views?
Oh, Ariel Camacho, I think.
Really? Like a cowboy?
Yeah.
It's funny, I've been watching.
Yeah.
I know what's going on.
A pesar de su corta edad, Ariel Camacho demostró un talento nato para la música.
Another question. Alexei PS pregunta, sus vidas antes y después de ser YouTuber. Muchas felicidades por el millón de suscriptores.
Oh, man. Before YouTube, I was giving up on the film industry because I'd spent like my childhood and university and so many years trying to get like a hosting job, and I was like turning 30 and I was like, oh, like I'm gonna be a construction worker or I'm gonna be like a FedEx delivery guy. Like I was starting to look for those jobs, delivering Red Bull and stuff. My resume would be like so much film and TV experience. I was having a hard time getting a job. They're like, you're so passionate, you've just got to keep going. And I'm like, but I want to get paid. So YouTube was like my last kick at the can, and I did not, for the life of me, I was like, this isn't gonna last. This is gonna be like Napster. This is gonna be like MSN Messenger. Then like these videos started really taking off. You know, about around the time I'd hit a million, which I think took me like 8 months to do. Like by then I'd like moved downtown. I bought like a really fancy car. I paid off my student debt. And like my life changed. It's like hitting the lottery. It felt like that. And I was like a kid in the candy store because the show that I built was exactly the kind of content I wanted to make. I wanted to be like an MTV host. So here I am like detailing artists' lives. They're interacting with it. Maybe not a person, but like over social media. I couldn't be happier. I couldn't believe that it all worked out. It was like so many years of trying so hard that it all finally came together. And I'm like super lucky. Like some days like the views aren't what I want them to be, or like, I don't know what to do. So like sometimes you get lost and it's like every day, but I do have to pinch myself because I'm just so fortunate. Yeah. And I work with really nice people.
Aww.
How's your life changed?
It's crazy because like before I was just like, I didn't know what to do. I just want to be like on television, like producing stuff. But now I'm just like, whoa, like I'm actually producing stuff. I'm being like a producer as well. And it's crazy that we have so much fun here. The thing that I love the most is that it doesn't feel like you're working. It feels like you're having fun.
But you are an amazing talent at like, not only is she writing these scripts, presenting it, she edits the videos, then uploading them, making thumbnails and like traction and monitoring and like projecting what to do next. It's like a crazy, it's a crazy amount of work. So thank you all who have subscribed and tell your friends to subscribe.
Yes.
Help this girl get to 2 million.
Yes, and then we can make my Before They Were Famous and that's gonna be interesting.
I think, yo, right now your channel is doing better than mine. You might actually pass me to 10 million.
No.
Like, it might happen. It might happen.
I don't think
so. It's okay if it does.
Okay, are you ready for another question? Misael Guía pregunta, ¿te agrada hablar de traperos o artistas actualmente populares por gusto personal o lo haces solo por lo mucho que significa para el canal por su difusión?
I love the hip hop videos because these people are like salt of the earth and like usually they come from like a background where they don't have a lot of money and like there's tragedy and stuff. And those are like the more compelling stories rather than like, I was born in Beverly Hills and my dad's a dentist. Like, who cares?
Yeah, like for me, it was hard to start with because I was not into that type of music that much. I did like it, but not like crazy. But when I started like researching on these artists, it was like fun. Migos for me was just like, fuck, they changed everything. They had nothing. And then they just like make this amazing music.
I remember not knowing the difference between Offset and
Takeoff.
Yeah,
me too. And now they are just like so popular. It's crazy. I enjoy it a lot. So, next question. Melissa Anaí del Ángel Hernández pregunta, ¿de dónde sacaron la idea para hacer estos tipos de videos? Muy buenos.
Before They're Famous, I guess it's pretty close to my heart. For one, I was always into celebrity and fame and stuff. So then I was looking up like, okay, well, Brad Pitt, he drove girls in a limo. Eminem was a cook. I'm like, so everyone has their like, you know, coming of age story. And it's really the only career where things can flip like a light switch and you can have, you know, fame and fortune and all the rest. So I was like into reading biographies, Jim Carrey, Russell Brand. These are like on my shelves. So then I'm like, if I care this much, other people are gonna care as well.
Yeah.
And then I just started doing the people that I cared about and then the ball got rolling and I'm like, I'm never gonna run out of people. There's so many people famous for so many different reasons.
And they are always new upcoming artists all the time.
A lot.
And only, like we have been working in the, like since January.
2016?
Yeah.
Wow.
3 years.
Wow. Boom. It's changed so, so much and so fast. But it's amazing. This is how it's gonna be. So I can only imagine what the future is gonna be. Yeah, I had something to say, but I forgot. I also realized that she has to add subtitles for everything I say.
Yeah, so it's fun, eh? Estoy muy agradecida con todos ustedes porque de verdad me mandaron muchas preguntas y quiero responder todas, pero hablamos mucho nosotros, lo siento. Valesca Farrugia, espero haberlo dicho bien, pregunta, ¿cómo logran conseguir tanta información acerca de los artistas?
I feel like every artist is different.
Yeah.
The YouTubers are the hardest to do. For my research, I always start on Instagram and Twitter. And then the thing is, to get like one of our videos to really pop, we're usually beating Wikipedia or like most online sources. So it's like a mix mash of their social media and interviews and video clips. And we just make it our own creation out of there.
Yeah, sometimes I have to go to like the sister's Instagram, you know?
Yeah,
like,
oh yeah.
Like the family, the relatives' Instagram, the relatives' Facebook. So you have to get like, you get really stalker.
No.
One of the like worst stalker things that I've done to get information about an artist, I sent Pablo Londra's mom like a friend request. I don't know, to get his baby pictures or something. I don't know. I was just like, hey, I need more info about this guy.
That's really funny.
So are you ready? I'm excited. I really wanted to.
Oh, it's time. Okay, before we crack this bad boy up again, this video has been sponsored by Fashion Nova. Men? And they also do Fashion Nova and ladies. Yay. But we just got to roll a short commercial because, well, they're helping us out, guys. Ailid works so hard, and the revenue we make off of YouTube, it's just not a lot. The main channel, we get paid in the US dollars, but then we get paid in pesos.
Yeah.
it's hard to keep things going. Of course, she busts her ass and she works so hard, but thanks to sponsors that come forward, it really helps. So let's take a look at Fashion Nova.
No se me preocupen, muchachos, porque Fashion Nova también pensó en ustedes y lanzó una línea de ropa masculina, por lo que ustedes no se quedarán solo mirando cómo las mujeres sí tenemos ropa económica y bonita al alcance de nuestros dedos y ustedes no. Ustedes también tienen miles de artículos para elegir. De hecho, Michael también recibió regalitos por parte de Fashion Nova, así es que les voy a dejar un link en la cajita de la descripción para que vean todas las posibilidades que tiene Fashion Nova para ustedes.
I'm wearing this dress as well.
If you want that dress, you can check out that link down below. Let them know we sent you guys. Also, be sure to subscribe, share the channel, help her out, because she's a very hard worker. Do you want? You should open it. It's yours.
Okay. It's the first time I'm doing this ever, like in my life, because the 100K.
Yeah. Did I open that?
Yeah.
And then we're gonna hang these on the wall here in the office. But this is like such a huge deal.
Ah.
It's like graduating from Harvard.
Yes!
Oh! Oh!
Wow! Yay! We have the plugs!
Wow, a million people. Oh my god. I've never seen one of these in person.
These are the new ones, right?
Yeah.
You actually have yours here.
What language is the letter in?
English.
Really?
Yeah, why? Maybe because it's Canadian.
Let's hear what Susan Wojcicki had to say to us. You're bigger than Vancouver, you're bigger than Venice, you're even bigger than Las Vegas. 1 million subscribers, maybe you've imagined that day for a long time, or maybe you never thought you'd grow so big. Either way, not much can match the satisfaction of finding out that your creativity, that your ideas, that your voice speaks to 1 million people across the globe. We know that being able to touch the lives of so many people is reward enough, but we're incredibly proud for all of you've done, so we'll hope you'll accept this Gold Creator Award as a token of our esteem. Wow. They said next one's gonna be 10 million. Ah! It's beautiful!
Look at it!
Okay, pass me mine.
Yeah. No, hold this. Jay!
Wow.
We should take these away. Bye. Jay!
It's like Papa Bear and Mama Bear. They kind of suit our personalities. Well, when you guys come by the office, you could come see them in person in Toronto. Again, huge congrats to Ailid. Let's give her a round of applause.
Jay!
I'm so proud of you.
Thanks.
Thank you guys.
I'm excited.
Nice to get to talk to you guys. We'll be down to do more of these videos, or Ailid to do her own before they're famous, or more personal stuff. Like, we've tried eating wings on here once.
Yeah, like when we get to 500K.
Ah.
We should do more of these videos. If you guys like more, like watching us together, I think I like it. I like doing these videos.
We can even go out and do stuff.
That would be cool. If you like to enjoy these, please let me know in the comment section, and we can do this. We can make fun videos.
Thanks, guys. Okay, bye.
Okay. Yeah, that's it. Nos vemos en el siguiente video. Les mando muchos besos y saludos a todos y gracias por haber visto el video. Bye.
Bye.
Yeah, it's done. Where did you put your gum?
Sure.
Sorry.
Saving those for later.